We're still early in the times of DDR5, and with most technology, it's always more expensive in the beginning. But is it actually worth it? We have looked into testing DDR4 up versus DDR5, and we will answer the question if the DDR5 is actually worth the money. Is the cost to performance ratio worth it? We decided to test this by building two identical computers. Well, at least as identical as they can be. Now you have to have different motherboards, one that is DDR5 compatible and one that is DDR4 compatible. And of course the memory sticks are different as well. But other than that, it is the same exact configuration. The two builds has an i7-12700KF processor. There is a 3070 Ti graphics card in it, and the motherboard is a Z690P. One is from Asus TUF and the other one is an Asus Prime. Now the memory is Kingston Fury Beast. One is the 3600 megahertz, that's the DDR4, and the other one is 4800 megahertz, that's the DDR5. It is, of course, in our new Silent Void case, which I personally love, but let's not get carried away here. We have tested in Cinebench, we've tested in IDA, we've tested in GTA 5, and we've tested in TimeSpy Extreme. And we've monitored the memory usage, we've monitored the temperatures, and we've done a mix of stress testing and rendering to see how well they perform. We wanted to do as broad of a test as possible, and that's why we've done in so many different programs. And I was somewhat surprised by the result of our tests. Now, we ran several tests to verify our results. What we concluded is that in most cases, the DDR4 and DDR5 machine, they went toe-to-toe in the tests. And in some of the tests, the DDR4 build actually beat the DDR5 marginally. We did not fiddle with the manual overclocking or anything like that, like we never do in our tests. Linus Tech Tip already mentioned this is one of his videos about DDR5 and said that you get next to nothing by manually changing the overclocking on your DDR5 RAM. So the big question is, why is DDR4 outperforming DDR5, or at least matching it? You have DDR5, which has a higher megahertz, so technically it should be faster. What many fail to take into consideration is the cache latency in the memory. The DDR5 has double the cache latency as the DDR5, at least at this point. And when you take that into the calculations, you will get memory speed that is somewhat similar to the DDR4, and in some cases even slower. Now you could mitigate this by moving onto the highest end of DDR5, like the 6200 megahertz, but you will end up paying 3 or 4 times the price of a DDR4 kit that will perhaps net you between 3% and 10% gain in performance. So paying between 300% and 400% price and gaining between 3% and 10% performance is just a horrible cost to performance ratio. And if you're after performance and if you want to be wise about your money, it is not the time to spend money on DDR5 yet. So what is the case here? Is DDR4 just better than DDR5? Well, you could say that we are in the beta stage of DDR5. We are seeing the first iterations, so it is much more expensive at this point, and the potential of DDR5 is so much better than the DDR4. We are just not utilizing it that well yet. On a DDR4, you are limited to 32 gigabytes of RAM per stick. On the DDR5, you can get up to 128 gigabytes per stick. I'm gonna correct myself real quick here. actually the limit for a single DDR4 stick is 64 gigabytes of RAM. Samsung actually managed to make a 256 gigabytes of RAM stick, but that was for servers. For regular desktop PCs, 64 gigabytes is the max for DDR4, whereas DDR5 has a theoretical cap at 512 gigabytes compared to the 64 gigabytes of DDR4. So the potential is through the roof. You can get much higher megahertz, and at some point they will be able to lower the cache latency, so you will get a product that will perform much better than the DDR4 RAM. It is just not there yet. This is the same thing you saw when DDR4 was released. When comparing to the DDR3, the earlier DDR4 memory sticks were slower, but they have been on the market for some time now, and we have been able to build better and faster memory sticks so that the DDR4 is now outperforming the DDR3 manifolds. So to sum it all up, should you upgrade to DDR5? No, we're not there yet. DDR5 is just not there yet, and it's still too expensive. You might look at this from the future and be like, oh, my sweet, sweet summer child, you know nothing. DDR5 has taken over the world and running it with immense power and speed and performance. Still not there yet, though.